Staying home for an extended period of time can feel mundane, unproductive, and flat out boring. It's so easy to do your work while laying down on a couch or the bed, which is where I find myself the most unproductive because of the ergonomic challenges and how easy it is to lose motivation, fall asleep, or watch TV. In an effort to be more productive while working from home and really spending all my time in the house, I'm going to share with you what I've done that has made me more satisfied with how I've spent my time inside. First thing to do is get ready as if you're going into the work office to increase your overall well-being. Improving the space you live in along with your work environment can make a major difference in your overall mood and productivity. Adding plants into my space have not only added a pop of color, but they also help you relax and unwind, which is something we all could benefit from during a time like this. Plants can improve air quality by removing harmful toxins. The greenery is good for the mind, body, and soul. They also reduce background noise level, which is something I greatly appreciate as a person who lives in an apartment, and they can improve sleep quality and stress relief. Making coffee is a daily routine I've added in the morning. Something about the process of making your own coffee gives you a sense of starting your day. As the aroma of fresh coffee fills the room, I pair my Bluetooth speaker to my device and select one of my favorite lo-fi or coffee shop playlists. Although I'm still in a house, this routine gives me a fresh feeling of inspiration to tackle whatever software development or YouTube video tasks I have for the day. What's going on, everyone? I've been trying to do more voiceover segments. The reason being is because B-roll with no audio, and by no audio, I mean no voiceovers, can get really boring really fast. And on top of that, I need a new mic for my camera. Someone mentioned in my previous video that it sounded a bit echoey when I'm talking to the camera opposed to using my microphone, which makes sense. And it's something I definitely am working on fixing because I know audio is really important and I want to give you all the best quality possible. Continuing on the topic of how I'm trying to stay productive while working from home and just some tips for working from home. One thing that I've been doing is working on my programming skill sets. Yes, I do write code for a living, but it's a bit different from working on passion projects. And I don't do as much JavaScript as I'd like to do. So I've been purposely working on my JavaScript skill sets so they don't get too rusty. And I'm also just spending this time to work on building a mobile application as well. And I'm still trying to figure out how I wanna do that. Do I wanna use like native iOS or do I wanna use something like JavaScript and Node.js and maybe package it up and build an installer. So I'm trying to stay motivated to work on things that are new, work on things that I wouldn't typically work on because I typically don't have the time. But since we spend so much time at home, I figured this would be a great time to work on a project I haven't been able to work on. Since we're on the topic of learning new things and starting those projects that you haven't had the time to start before, let's hear a word from our sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where millions of people from all around the world come together to take the next step in their creative journey, whether that be becoming a UI designer or a photographer in 2020. One thing I love about Skillshare is that members get unlimited access to thousands of courses. So that means if you want to take a cooking class on a Monday, Python automation class on a Thursday, you can do that. And that's really beneficial, especially for someone who is a creative like myself. I'm interested in so many things. One moment I'm knee deep in TikTok. The next moment I'm knee deep in infrastructure and architecture or how Python automation can help me create Spotify playlists. And I'm not just gonna talk about it, I'm gonna be about it. A video about front-end development, I talked about a JavaScript course that I was taking and now I'm taking the next step and I'm gonna take a React course because I really need some guidance on starting a React application. The course is called React for Beginners, Build an App and Learn the Fundamentals by Ryan Johnson. The first 1,000 people who select this link that will be linked down in the description box will get 2 free months of premium access to Skillshare. And for those of you all who want to take it to the next step and you know you want an annual memberships are less than $10, which is a great deal considering you are investing in yourself. So thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Back to the main content. Going to the gym was a big part of my daily routine. I enjoy lifting weights, playing basketball, and just moving my body and challenging it physically. Breaking up my day with a workout to release endorphins that trigger a positive feeling in the body gives me inspiration to continue to strive for the goals I want to achieve physically and mentally. I also spend some time on my creative side doing TikTok videos because they really do challenge my dancing skills and give me joy. Last but not least, tidying up your workspace. There's a saying that if your room is a mess, it feels like your life is a mess too. And I also think the same applies to your workspace. Having a functional, decluttered, and organized physical and virtual desktop can increase productivity and decrease psychological distress from being overwhelmed by clutter and disarray. With an intentional, organized desktop, you can directly increase productivity by easily finding what you need, creating folders for reusable assets, and playlists for different music you like to listen to based on the setting you're in. Being able to work on passion projects more often because you can easily access their location and start working from where you started. I know these are just a few examples of how you can be more productive at home, but it starts with the small things in life to reach those big goals. Once again, thank you Skillshare for sponsoring this video, and I'll see you soon. Stay safe and healthy. Peace.